Hey guys, welcome back. So, following on from my four magic frequencies four series, today I wanted to tackle toms. Now, the problem with toms is not necessarily four frequencies, there can be more. So let's jump into Pro Tools and I'll show you how I process toms and how you can do the same. Today we're working on the song Come and Haunt Me by Mars Blossom, and let's have a listen to just the raw toms. And in the context of the full drum mix. So they're not sounding bad right off the bat. Now there are two methods of going about this. You can either do it with a visual EQ such as SSL EQ, which is what I'm using, or Pro Q3 or something similar. And this is what the general frequency curve will look like. If I enable both of these, you'll hear what the toms sound like with the EQ. So without and with. Cool. Now, in keeping with my use of SSL plugins, let's hear what this sounds like with the SSL. Now, at the moment, I've got a little bit of a low boost, well, a little bit, 15 dB. So I guess your first frequency will be 100 Hz. So this is where the meat of the actual drum is going to be. Now, the thing you have to keep in mind for toms is this frequency is going to move down as you go around the kit. So a floor tom is going to have a lower fundamental than a rack tom, and then it depends on which tuning you're using. So you may need to sweep around to find your sweet spot. But for the rack tom, it is around about 112 Hz. Let's just blank off these others and let's listen to that low boost. So for your next frequency, we're talking low mids, 400 to 600, something along those lines. Maybe even as low as 300. Again, depends on the source. We want to suck a big boatload of that out, so I'm going to go like 9 dB, maybe even more. Yeah, that's better. See how it's cleaned that right up? And without. And with. Starting to sound a lot more full. Third frequency. That is going to be around about a K. So again, this one can vary wildly, anywhere between 700 to like 2K. Again, I'm going to suck a big bunch of this out. So let's go 9 dB again. Let's go 12. Turn it off. Starting to come to life a little bit more. Now, your fourth frequency. This is going to be a top-end boost. What you really want is the stick attack. Now, I like the SSL for top-end boost, but I would always prefer the sound of a Pultec. So for this, I'm going to add a Pultec next to it. Now, the Pultec, I'm going to actually boost a little bit more low-end, but I'm going to boost an absolute shit ton of top-end at around about 5K. So when we turn the Pultec on, let's listen to what that sounds like. So if we take both of those off and on, and now if we turn those off but we put the XEQ on, we get, and if I turn them off and put the SSL on the Pultec back in, so if anything I'm hearing that a little bit this here in the SSL, the low band, can come out slightly because we are boosting it in the Pultec as well. See, now it's a bit thinner. Let's boost it back up. And let's add a little bit more juice on the Pultec. That's nice. Alright, I'm going to copy this over to the floor tom as a starting point, but on the floor tom we're going to sweep around. Somewhere about there, they sound quite balanced to me. Maybe a little bit more low in the floor tom. Nah, that's better. As you can see, in the XEQ in the floor tom, and then if I open this one also, that one sat around 104, whereas the floor tom is sitting at around 80. So there is a little bit of a difference. And on that basis, we might move the pull tech down to 60 for the floor. Yeah, that's better. Boost a bit more. Nice. The next thing you want to do is a little bit of compression. So I usually go with a Black 1176, and you want to be hitting, you know, a few dB. If we open the floor one. So the floor one's getting absolutely slapped, but if you turn the compression off and then you turn it back on, it kind of sucks that low in a little bit, but it makes the tom sound a lot tighter. So if we put all of this out and then we put the full drum mix in, and then we put it back in again. So much better. Let's listen to it in the context of the song. Nice. Now, you will have noticed, I also have the drum verb turned off. Well, that's because in the actual mix of this song, the artist wanted the drums to be quite reverby. But that doesn't bode very well for teaching you how to EQ toms, because everything is wild and boomy sounding. I also muted the rooms because the rooms are quite loud. So in the drum mix, if I put the rooms back in, and if I put the reverb back in, so if you listen to that in the mix, as you can hear, they cut through quite nicely. They don't sound too overwhelming. And that's how I generally process toms. And it, again, doesn't matter the genre, doesn't really matter the tempo, just general starting points. So essentially, if I was to describe it vocally, what you'd be looking for is a boost on the fundamental of the tom. You're then looking to suck all the mid-range out, and then you want some attack where the actual stick click goes. And if you do this on your toms, providing the decent at the source, you'll be pretty much all the way there. Thanks for joining me today. I'll see you again next time.